In this lesson, I'm going to cover the different types of Elastic Load Balancer available on AWS, and you do need to understand for the exam which one to use for specific use cases. The first type is the Application Load Balancer, the ALB. The ALB will listen at the request level, so it's listening at layer 7. That means the actual listener is using the HTTP or HTTPS protocol. And the ALB can route connections based on information at that level. So for example, it supports path-based routing. That means the path in the URL can be used to determine where to send the connection. So which group of instances on the back end to send the connection to. It also supports host-based routing. That means it's checking the domain name and making a routing decision there. Query string parameter-based routing checks for query strings in the URL and will then route based on that information. So the ALB is quite intelligent in how it can check this information and make routing decisions. The ALB supports instances, IP addresses, Lambda functions, and containers as targets. Next, we have the Network Load Balancer, the NLB. This operates at the connection level, so it's more around layer 4. It's using IP protocol data to make routing decisions. The NLB will listen on TCP, TLS, UDP, and TCP underscore UDP. Both the ALB and the NLB are the newer generation of load balancers. Now, the NLB is really good for when you need ultra high performance and extremely low latency, or if you need TLS offloading at scale. So that means it's processing the encryption for TLS connections and offloading that from your backend instances. So if you see exam questions asking for a very low latency load balancer, it's likely to be the NLB. And then the other key piece of information that's going to help you determine which type of load balancer to use out of these two is the protocol. So if you're looking for UDP or TCP or TLS, then that's going to be a network load balancer. If you need to route based on information at the HTTP or HTTPS level, that's going to be the ALB. Next, we have the classic load balancer, the CLB. Now, you really shouldn't see this on the exam anymore. There could very occasionally be a reference to it, but it's very unlikely to be the correct answer. AWS don't really want you to be using this anymore. They'd prefer you to use an ALB or an NLB for the same sort of use cases you might have used a CLB for in the old days before the newer generations came along. The CLB performs routing at layer 4 and layer 7, but it doesn't have anywhere near the intelligence of the ALB or the NLB. Lastly, we have the Gateway Load Balancer, the GLB. This is very new, and it has just started appearing on the exam recently, so you may see some questions. The GLB is used in front of virtual appliances, such as firewalls, intrusion detection systems, intrusion prevention systems, and deep packet inspection systems. It operates at layer 3, and it listens for all packets on all ports. It then forwards the incoming traffic to the target group specified in listener rules, and it exchanges traffic with appliances using the Genève protocol on port 6081. Now, I just want to cover the ALB and the NLB side by side. For most load balancing use cases, these are going to be the ones that you're going to use, so you really need to know how to determine which one you should be using for your use case. So remember, with the OSI layer, the ALB is at layer 7 and the NLB is at layer 4. That means these two load balancers are using different information to make their decisions on where to forward connections. The target type for an ALB can be an IP address, an instance, a Lambda function, or a container. With the NLB, it can be an IP address or an EC2 instance. For protocol listeners, the ALB supports HTTP and HTTPS, and gRPC is supported through HTTP2. The NLB listens on TCP, UDP, and TLS. For private link, which we'll cover later in the VPC section, there's no support for the ALB, but there is for the NLB. For static IP addresses, the ALB does not have them, whereas the NLB does support static IP addresses. That means the actual nodes of your load balancer that run in your subnets can have static addresses. That's good for whitelisting and firewalls, and we'll cover that more later on. You get HTTP header-based routing with the ALB, but you do not with the NLB. For source IP preservation, the ALB uses X forwarded for. That means the information about the IP address of the client is forwarded in the X forwarded for header, whereas it's native in the protocol data with the NLB. For SSL termination, you have load balancer terminated with the ALB and load balancer or target with the NLB. Let's finish off going over a few use cases. For the ALB, you'd use this when you have web applications and layer 7 routing, microservices architectures such as Docker containers, and Lambda targets. For the NLB, TCP and UDP based applications, where you need ultra low latency, and you might need static IP addresses. It's also used with VPC endpoint services. And then lastly, for the gateway load balancer, you'd use this for load balancing virtual appliances, such as intrusion detection systems, intrusion prevention systems, next generation firewalls, web application firewalls, and distributed denial of service protection systems. It also integrates with auto scaling groups for elasticity, and you can apply network monitoring and logging for analytics.